Hey everyone, it's Sarah, and today I'm going to show you how to stamp soap. The first thing you're going to need is a soap stamp. I purchased two from Dave at LaserCutz on Etsy, and he was really easy to work with. He took my logo and told me what would work, what wouldn't. I was really worried because my logo has a very thin script font, and I didn't want the pieces to be too thin because it would break off chunks of soap. He will give you suggestions on how to tailor your logo to work with soap stamping. Another thing that I really liked about purchasing from LaserCutz is that even though they're based in the UK, I got my soap stamps really fast. I am an instant gratification kind of person. If I have to wait for something, I get really impatient. And they were here, I think within the next week. They came here the next week, and that was me working with Dave, and then he made them over the weekend, and then they arrived that next week. So they do come very, very quickly. You will need a rubber mallet, and this is just a plain rubber mallet. You can find it at Lowe's. It's about $5. Now, there's nothing fancy about a rubber mallet. It's just a plain rubber mallet, but you don't want to get a regular non-rubber mallet because it's going to put way too much force behind, and you kind of need that soft blow to push the stamp in without breaking the stamp or completely demolishing your soap. So you'll need a soap stamp, you'll need a rubber mallet, and of course you're going to need some soap. Now that you have your supplies, you're probably wondering, well, when do I stamp my soap, Sarah? Like, do I do it right away? Do I wait a little bit? It really depends on a few different variables. First, your recipe. If you have more liquid oils in your recipe than solid oils, you're going to have to wait longer. Otherwise, your bar is going to be too mushy and it's going to make a big sloppy stamp mess. On the other hand, if you guys have more solid oils in your recipe, then you can stamp a little bit sooner than you could if you were making like a castile. Another thing to think about when you're stamping your soap, you kind of will build an intuition of when it's ready. And I know that sounds corny and like I am the soap whisperer. It's not like that at all. You can tell after you cut a bar and just feel it if it's ready to stamp or not. Now, typically you want to stamp your soap within 48 hours of cutting it. And that is not a hard and fast rule. That is just like a general guideline to go by. So not all soaps are the same, and you're really going to have to just kind of get a feel for it, practice a few times, make a few mistakes. I've got some really ugly looking stamped soaps that are just like gouged into the soap, and it's okay. I found that one of the best things that you can do to see if your soap is ready to stamp is to practice on a little tester piece. We all usually get those little end pieces that, you know, you use for testing or samples, whatever. I like to use those end pieces as my kind of soap stamp tester thing. I know that if the end piece comes out looking nasty, I don't want to stick it on a regular bar of soap, or I'm going to have a really ugly looking bar of soap. Now that I've said all that, it's time for me to stop talking, start stamping. I've got some soap that's ready to go. I'm going to go ahead and cut it in my bud cutter and show you how I do it. Okay, so here's my little tester piece, and here's my soap stamp. When it came in, this whole part right here was completely clean and clear. I wanted to make it a little bit easier for me to see which way was up, so I just put two little arrows on there just for ease of use. So what you're going to do is put your stamp on there, and wherever you may want it. I like to have mine in the lower right corner. You can do it in the middle, you can do it up top, wherever. But this is the place that I like to stamp. Grab my mallet right here. I'm going to stamp once in the middle, top, bottom, left, and right. Holding the base, just nice and light little taps, nothing crazy, and then one more time in the middle. Okay, and then kind of wiggle your stamp very slightly back and forth and take it out. And you can see this left a really nice, clean, clear impression, so I know that the rest of my soap is ready to go. Now that your soap is completely stamped, it's ready to bevel and pretty up any way that you want it to. The last thing you're going to want to do after you've stamped your soap is you're going to have to clean your stamp. You'll see looking around the edges that you have little bits and pieces of soap stuck on there, and you want to get that off so that you don't have it sticking to your next batch and it can leave little extra soap bits around your impressions if you get too many soap bits on there. So the way that you clean it, you don't use anything hard. You want to use a nice soft toothbrush and under running water, just gently brush it off and it'll come right off no problem. I have a lot of swirls and swoops and loops and it comes out easy as pie. But that is how you stamp soap.